Modern-day enterprises are highly complex and multifaceted, from their business models via business processes to the supporting IT systems. How can they focus on what is essential, assess possible risks, or develop new business models? Henderik Proper and his research team at the Luxembourg Institute of Science and Technology focus on the use of enterprise models to answer such challenging questions.
Just like a building or a city has a design that you can draw, enterprise models are drawings of an organization with all its aspects. You can touch the facade of a building, you can walk around in a city. An organization, yes, you can go to a bank, but the organizational structure is abstract. And the buildings, the IT systems, that may be tangible, but generally they are abstract, intangible things. So that makes it a bit difficult also to talk about this topic, but also to work with models.
If we are to understand them truly, the abstract business processes and organizational structures first have to be brought into a clearer and more tangible form. A promising way to do so, the researchers have discovered, is to manipulate such models via intuitive user interfaces, which have also been developed at LIST. Here, for example, they are working on a project aimed at optimizing the logistics of construction sites. Their models enable companies to quickly identify the consequences any changes in one area would have for the rest of the company. Before receiving the funding to build up an expert group in Luxembourg through the PEARL program of the Luxembourg National Research Fund, Henderik Proper worked at different universities as well as in industry.
Around 2008, I was working in industry, quite happy in the sense of in an applied context, but I was getting a little bit unhappy about the lack of room to reflect on things. After moving between industry and academia a number of times, I thought it would actually be good to land in the middle at an RTO organization, so research and technology organization like ours, LIST. So the core group around me here in Luxembourg is about 5-6 people. Next to that, we work closely together with people at the university. We work closely together with people in other departments and groups within our institute. And of course, with the people from the University of Antwerp, the University of Nijmegen. So that leads to a number of concentric circles. And we're part of this broader network.
Henderik Proper knows from experience that people's acceptance of a model increases when a model is presented as a game. In this form, decision makers can, for example, enact or play through the planned changes in an enterprise with all their consequences entirely risk-free.
For instance, you might want to use a game to let senior management experience risks. And then you need to tune the game to illustrate in terms of their enterprise what the risks are. It might also be a way to teach people or to validate how a business process runs. And then you need to work with the people who do the business process and let them play the game and then reflect on, is this the way you do the business process or is it different? And then you get spontaneous reactions. So they use it as a means of validation. So in general, that depends on the purpose of the model and the message you want to communicate. You need to tune the game to that.
Whether a simple board game or a high-tech simulation, research results become tangible through gaming, making models more effective in helping decision makers make the right decisions.
If you are thinking about possible changes, you need to assess the options. You need to design different scenarios. And each of those scenarios translates itself to a new set of models. And then based on these different scenarios, you can also compare them in terms of properties. What is more secure? What is more agile? What is more cost effective? How can I earn more money? And all these trade-offs can be made in terms of those models.
Their research, however, extends well beyond the world of models. To stay grounded in reality, Henderik Proper and his team also conduct field research. The increase in networking and mobile applications in recent years has given rise to an exciting new field for the researchers. there are a growing number of online platforms presenting goods and services in the consumer's immediate environment in real time. The experts are studying, for example, the use of a mobile phone app for tourists in Luxembourg. From this, they can discern the principles of how these new businesses are organized and how they can best be represented as models. Every branch, every company, every organization is different. What are these differences? What are, at the same time, commonalities? These are difficult questions that call for new ideas and solutions every time a new enterprise, its business model, or its organizational processes are to be analyzed. An unexpected source of inspiration for Henderik Proper was his great passion for photography.
I like the abstraction. I like the challenge also of finding the right abstraction. It's relatively easy to make abstractions, but what is needed in a situation? What message do you want to get across with your model? For who do you need it? And those are fascinating things. And that might be resonated by also one of my hobbies. I like to take photos, landscape photos. Also there, trying to find the right angle, the right abstraction of what you want to convey, but what you saw. And that's a challenge. And with enterprise modeling, we're doing something similar, but then for clarifying the structures of an enterprise. It's taking photos of the enterprise.
There is even an entirely new, exciting development in Luxembourg that has recently caught the researchers' interest. The country has taken on the challenge to start space mining, to mine for raw materials on asteroids and comets. But how does one go about successfully establishing such an industry if there is no prior model to follow? The knowledge of the enterprise modelers at LIST could help turn such a vision into reality. As the first scientist to be funded through the FNR's PEARL program, Henderik Proper was able to set up a permanent expert group at LIST, which is successfully tackling enterprise modeling challenges. It's an example of sustainable and practically oriented research that could benefit the economy and society in Luxembourg and beyond.